for those who are not familiar with the concept of club baseball, the collegiate club baseball program essentially allows students the opportunity to continue playing competitive college baseball through high school. And the beauty about the club baseball is that these organizations are all student-run. So everything from scheduling, travel planning, equipment purchasing, even fundraising, everything on and off the field falls directly back on the team, on the student officers that do it. So they get firsthand experience of what all these varsity programs go through, but they're doing that on their own. So they get firsthand access into the hardships of finding practice time, finding fields, raising money, all for the love of the game. They play for themselves, and they do it because they want to keep playing baseball after high school. A lot of these kids could have played D2, D3, but they didn't want to devote their full time to, you know, all the practices and the rigorous schedule, to devoting all that time to the baseball team. They still want to have fun, go to the big schools they want to go to, and play some baseball at the same time.
When you look at this tournament that's coming to Pittsburgh, and you tell me the Division II tournament, so let's start there. You told me earlier the NCBA, 281 teams represented in 44 states, but people look at the bracket, teams are going to be here at our place, and they see Penn State on there, so they think automatically of a big Division I school. Talk about how you separate Division I and Division II teams when it comes to club baseball.
Yeah, absolutely. Any new teams that come on to the NCBA are automatically placed in Division II. We've gotten to the point where we're fortunate to be everywhere across the United States, so there's always going to be room for new D2 teams. And at the same time, these new D2 teams, have to prove themselves on and off the field. They have to establish themselves, get a great system going to where everything's basically turnkey. And once they've established themselves, they can move on up to D1, where we pretty much call it the big show. Everyone wants to be there because we really put a lot of bells and whistles into our D1 teams. But at the same time, D2 is a great place to start out. And we still take great care of them down here at D2 as well. But that's the main difference, is just being established, being organized, kind of learn the ropes a little bit down at D2.
We're chatting with Eric Curator. He is the director of Division II operations for the National Club Baseball Association and the Division II World Series at JC Ballpark in Pittsburgh starting next Friday the 20th. Eric, in terms of this, you see these teams, and again, I think of it as a standpoint of I see a Penn State or a school that's very recognizable, and big schools, there are probably going to be some pretty good players that just didn't play in college, but they still do want to remain competitive. In your best estimation, how would you describe the level of play to people?
Yeah, absolutely. As you were saying, I'm sure a lot of these kids at Penn State or Maryland, at these bigger schools, they could have went to the smaller D2, D3 NCAA schools around them, but they wanted to go to these Big Ten schools to get the experience of being at a Big Ten school or a big ACC school. We get this question a lot, and the equivalent I usually give them is a D2, NCAA, D3 equivalent for on the field. A lot of these kids are very, very good. They just didn't want to, give up all their time to the varsity baseball program at the school they wanted to go to. They wanted to, go to the school of choice while still playing baseball.
Robert County Convention and Visitors Bureau, he works hard to bring events like this to Pittsburgh, and JC Ballpark has been around since 1940, I think. An old farm team used to play there, so it has those pro dimensions, if you will, but the turf field, the cover seating, all that stuff. Talk about your impression after you guys had been at JC Ballpark last year.
Yeah, we can't speak enough about PJ Harris and the work he did with us. He actually reached out to us and got our attention about JC Ballpark and put it on the map. So we started looking into it. We started talking details. And last year was our first year there, and it exceeded all expectations. The field is great. The city's great. It gives us everything we want, all the resources we could ever ask for. The turf field is fantastic. And from a baseball point of view, it plays great. And from my point of view as a tournament director, I couldn't be happier, because if it pours one night, the field can be playable the next day. So it's very relieving to have that as an asset to us. And obviously the city is great, as I was saying before. We have a lot of great sponsors on board. We utilize them, the teams utilize them, and the hotel's great. We're up at the Lamplighter and its suites. They take care of us. The whole package, really, is fantastic. We love being in Pittsburgh, Kansas, and we'd love to stay here as long as we're allowed.
Again, Eric Curator with us, the Division II Director of Operations for the National Club Baseball Association, their D2 World Series in Pittsburgh next week. Eric, in terms of the location, you have Penn State and Maryland back east. I see a Texas school on the bracket. I see San Diego way out west. And so does central location like this within the country, does that factor into it at all?
Oh, absolutely. It's just one of the perks of Pittsburgh, Kansas. Obviously, Pittsburgh is centrally located in the United States and Kansas. as you were mentioning, we got schools all across the country. So when you pick something centrally located, it's great for the teams because obviously it's in a very central location. So all the teams, we're not playing any bias to the East Coast or the West Coast or anything. And it fits our league well, too, because fortunately we are across the whole U.S. So when you get all these districts, we call them districts as opposed to like the SEC or the ACC, the big-time conferences.
Mm-hmm.
When you get eight districts all over the country, all eight winners are, you know, traveling the same amount, if you will, except for obviously a couple. St. Louis is very close, and Chattanooga is decently close, too. But it's great for us, and we're happy to be here.
I know Pittsburgh State, our university here, which is a Division II school, they had a first year for a club team this year and unfortunately did not win their district in Indiana. But as a whole, when you talk about 281 teams across 44 states, do you feel like as far as a state of the union, things are in pretty good shape for the NCBA?
Yeah, absolutely. We're so excited with what we got going on here. We've been around since 2000, I believe, the first year. My boss, the president, Sandy Sanderson, started it with about 24 teams, I believe, in 2000. 16 years later, we're up to 281. I know in a couple of years we're going to be starting a Division III league, just because we're getting that much interest from schools all around the country. So we're very excited where we are now and very excited where we're going.